This video is going to show you how to measure a string pot with Simcenter Testlab. String pot has a string, goes up and down there, and there's a coiled spring here that keeps it taut, and it outputs a voltage that's proportional to the displacement of the string. And we'll set it up from scratch here in Testlab, so I'll double click, and then I'm going to pick Testlab Signature and start up Signature Acquisition. I'll open a default empty project by clicking on the white icon here. And once the software is started, I'll go to channel setup. And here I have my string pot attached to channel 1, which is input 1 over here. And I'll type in a name, string pot, so I know what that channel has on it. And under input mode here, I'm going to pick potentiometer. Pot and string pot is short for potentiometer. So this is a VB8 card that has special mode to support string pots. It's going to measure a displacement. I'm not really going to care about the calibration factor right now because I'm about to calculate it, but I should give it a voltage supply. So now it's powering the string pot so that it can output a signal to the SCADIS. I'll go to calibration next, and in the upper right here, I'll pick DC calibration, and I can type some values that I'd like to measure with the string pot to calibrate it. So 0, 5, and 10 here. I'll put a measuring device over here. You might have something that's a little more elaborate or thorough, but right now you can see that I have the string pot located at 0, so I'll measure the 0 value. And it shows that voltage over here. This is auto-scaled, so don't worry if it's going up and down because these are very, very minute differences. And when it's done measuring, or I can hit stop, I've measured the 0 value. Now I can move this over to 5 here. And once I'm at 5, I can go ahead and hit start. And then I can do the same thing. I can move over to 10 with the string pot. And I will measure 10. If I've done a good job, I should have a nice line down here. And these points, 0, 5, and 10, should be right on the line. And then I can hit accept because it's calculated the slope of this line and an offset. Now, if for some reason, you know, the string pot was not hooked up properly or whatever, and I was measuring some value way over here when I went to 5, that would show up in the line. So I'm hitting start here, and I'll hit stop. And you can see that the points are no longer along the line. Now it's possible to remeasure a given point. So if I go back to 5 here, I'll remeasure it and we'll see if we can get it back to where it was. And now you can see we got points along the line again. All right, so after calibrating, we're ready to measure. We'll go here and I can open a display and maybe I want to see this versus time. So I'll change the format to real. And under more, we can say we'd like to see 20 seconds worth of time when we're measuring the string pot. In the data explorer here, I can go to online data, fixed sampling, monitor, time history, and drop the time history in the display. And that will show the time history in the monitor folder, whether I'm just armed or whether I'm measuring. And now as I move the string pot back and forth, I can actually see the displacement in real time. And then I can go ahead and hit measure and start measuring. And that's all there is to measuring a string pot. Thank you.